With many taking to the streets in cities across the countries, Americans are being forced to defend themselves. And as One America's Pearson Sharp explains, that means our Second Amendment rights are more important now than ever before.
The Second Amendment is one of many amendments that make up the United States Bill of Rights. The amendments made to the United States Constitution were a result of the citizens demanding a guarantee of their basic freedoms. The Second Amendment states clearly that a well-regulated militia, being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. The Founding Fathers studied the trials and errors of once powerful civilizations and learned from the mistakes made by their feudal forefathers in Europe before then creating the framework for the free world. This amendment allows citizens of the United States their right to defend themselves from a tyrannical government, as well as grant the right of gun ownership to individuals for purposes that include self-defense. Keeping and bearing arms comes with responsibility.
Throughout history, the first step of any tyrannical government, from socialist leaders like Stalin to Hitler to Mao Zedong, has been to confiscate its citizens' weapons and deny them their right to bear arms. And now America's own socialists are doing the same thing. While peaceful, law-abiding citizens simply try to protect their families from the violent mob, the government is turning on them and defending the criminals prowling the streets. In Missouri, the local government is charging a 60-year-old couple with felonies for standing their ground and defending their home. And why? Because they had guns. But the terrorists in the crowd who broke down the gate to the privately owned street to trespass and vandalize private property and threaten innocent citizens also had guns. So what's the difference? Well, when violent socialist gangs of thugs and murderers proudly display their weapons, like these anarchists in Seattle, the same group of people who murdered two innocent teenagers, including a young black man, the media and the liberal elite defend them as the best of our democratic ideals. That's the exact phrase LA Mayor Eric Garcetti used to describe the violent Black Lives Matter and Antifa terrorists in Portland, who attacked police, burned buildings, and tried to destroy their own city. But not only are you not allowed to own guns, but extremist Democrats in cities like New York are working hard to disband their police, so you'll have no protection at all. In New York, murders are up 23% this year, and shooting incidents are up 130%, with some 400 people being shot just since Memorial Day, while Socialist Mayor Bill de Blasio claims it's the safest city in America. Now, city councils are actually issuing travel advisories for places like New York, urging residents not to go because it's too dangerous. And this is just the beginning. Meanwhile, the radical left mayor of Chicago is calling for more gun control in a city that's one of the most violent and dangerous in America, with 65 people shot and 10 people killed in one weekend. This is the America of the radical Marxist left. Criminals will always have guns. The question is, will you? Patricia and Mark McCloskey did nothing wrong. They protected their private property, and most importantly, no one got hurt. But they're being vilified by the extremists who want to take your guns away. Extremists like George Soros, who supported and funded the election of the St. Louis prosecutor attacking the McCloskeys. Now is the time to arm yourself. If you don't have a gun, exercise your Second Amendment right and make sure you have the ability to defend yourself when the Antifa and Black Lives Matter brown shirts come to your door. Because the radical Marxist left want to make sure the mob does come to your door, and soon. And as they quickly move to defund law enforcement and pull police off our streets, your gun is your best and perhaps only way to keep your family safe. And Americans seem to be getting the message. Right now, gun sales are surging to all-time highs, with 40% of sales going to first-time gun buyers. So support your local businesses, get registered, and buy a gun. Join a gun club, support the NRA, and make sure our generation isn't the last generation to enjoy the liberty of owning firearms. For One America News, I'm Pearson Sharp.
Want to see more videos like this?
Visit onn.com for immediate access to all the clips you've been waiting to see.